We just want to drop it. I'm sorry, man.
Just get rid of all the stuff off your screen.
I just want a static logo.
Okay, we're off and running. I didn't see who broke Grey, so it must be Paul, I think. And he's on the Reds. Okay, we caught up. Yeah, that's a great shot from Paul. He's off to a good start here. The best way to play against Yasser is to keep him sat in his chair. John Gillan and Danny Tyler are just about to start on the other table. We'll periodically pop across to that one as well. Paul's played that very well indeed. Yeah, good shot. Surprisingly, we're at the semi-final stage and we've not actually seen anything of Yasser on the stream yet. We like to get him on as often as we can because he's entertaining, to say the least. Unpredictable. Very flamboyant. But at this moment in time, he's sat on his backside. Oh, Paul's played that so well. So well, great shot. So we're still on races to seven because it's quite late, so we don't want to be here all night. Oops, giving him an extra frame there. Great finish from Paul, and I do believe that was a break and clear. So
if I missed a break disc, Paul,
that's the sort of standard that we want to see.
Well, it's unbelievable. You leave for a minute and you get a break dish.
Yeah.
Have you looked at these? Called it first thing, Yas will win it. Mark Aist. Yes. Kev says, come on, Paul, at the nugget tickle. It makes Steve Davis look interesting.
Well, he certainly put on a good show in that first for him, to be fair. Great break dish.
Wow, what a break.
Wow. Yasser's.
That is ridiculous. He absolutely pummeled them.
The last money match he played, his break let him down a little bit, so he's obviously been working on it.
Yeah, I think he spent some time on it, didn't he?
Yeah, because that was special.
Well, when he comes up next, last series, which were after his money match, wasn't it? He said he'd been practicing his break because it had let him down big style. So what do we think, Paul, here? Yellows?
Well, I know, Reds, I think.
Do you think, yeah?
Just. No, yellow. Well, no. I've changed my mind again, Daz. I think. Toss a coin. Yellows. Just, I think, just purely because of that red in the top left-hand corner.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at.
But he might be looking to get into that off the one in the middle.
Back goes in off the red, into the centre, does it? Or is it just too far forward, that?
Debatable.
Well, he's going yellows. There we go. That's,
Yeah, he's played that well. The yellow is a bit unlucky with the yellow, but it's just rolled behind the red. He might choose to be bold and just get on that yellow and play the plant. Or he might just try and disturb it from here. Yeah, he's disturbed it. Needs to get lucky. Well, he's left a plant.
Yeah, it's been all right there. Yeah, he's going to take this now and then across for the plant.
Yep. He's played it well.
I'll do for me.
Our referee for the day, Pete Arundel, has just suggested that for the final, just have a lag. Well, that'll do for me. I doubt the players would agree to that, though. Oh, very good shot from Yasser. So, all of a sudden, this break dish opportunity looks a lot more appetising. Well, he's manufactured this out of nowhere.
He certainly has. Well, that's one thing we ask. He does stuff like that.
Look at that. He's got a... he's got a blackout, but...
Yeah, just maybe not enough.
He's certainly in a better position than it was, though, Daz.
Yeah, it's definitely in a better position than it was. It does go into two pockets at least.
Yeah.
You said, do you clip this in the middle? The bottom?
I mean, I'd be taking the top one first, but...
Can we doubt Yassi's...
Nope.
And that's a great, great shot. So,
played it at pocket
just
pace,
play this
gives
now.
It, gives it every opportunity to drop.
Plays this, black into the bottom left-hand pocket.
He'd prefer not to be straight on this yellow, but I don't think he'll mind too much leaving a long black. Just managed to get a little bit of angle off it.
Yeah, just wanted to get a little bit closer to it, maybe, but I don't know. I think I'd have preferred the longer, straighter one.
Yeah, I would probably, but I... You got a back Yasser here for to break this right back at Paul, which is done.
And he has done. Well, fantastic.
Two frames, two visits, two break dishes. How's that?
Yeah, it's Kev's and I hope Pete Arundel's bow tie straight.
Oh, it is now. Yeah, it's...
When we're a proper tied bow tie on the final.
Well, he's got a ball. Wow, there's an opportunity.
Mr. Lamb's got some money matches here, planning in at the look of it.
Provisionals.
My
side's going to confirm the date. It's just going to confirm the date on Tuesday.
Ooh. Well, there we go. Can we tell him who's playing?
No, he's not confirmed it yet.
Not yet.
Well, we've just seen two names.
Yes, that's fantastic.
Next to each other for a potential money match here, and it would be a stormer. We'd have to sell tickets, I think, Daz.
That's going to be a belter, is that one?
Let's hope it gets confirmed. We'll wait till it's confirmed before we give it out. But
two quality players.
Be very excited. Well, Paul's chosen nominated reds.
Dare we say we're going to have three break dishes on the trot?
Well, this one's not easy, is it, Daz, from here?
No.
You won't be fancying the reds from here, but from what he's done so far, I certainly wouldn't back against him either.
Yes, he's just got a comment there from Kev Holland saying he couldn't manage it in the world final. He did point that out, actually, that it was a proper tied bow tie.
Yeah.
Not a clip on.
What a
Not a strap on.
Yeah, not a strap on.
So unbelievably, Paul has chosen to fudge. I think it was the right option actually to take the fudge option there.
Yeah, he played. He'd
have been chasing an almost impossible finish from where he was. But Yas,
I'm going to say something that Yas likes to do.
Answers on a postcard.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think he went for the pot there.
I think he did as well. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not like Yasser to miss by so much, though.
Yeah, Kev says that's a poor excuse about it being a proper bow tie.
Yeah, there's not a lot here for Paul. There's no real attacking options. There's no real defensive options.
No, it's a tough one. It's a bit of a.
Tell you what.
Well, it's deep. Well, yeah.
Yeah, I think that was just one of those shots where you don't have a shot, so you just do something.
You get them now and again, don't you? Where there's really nothing on. You can't see anything. You can't. You think of a decent shot to play.
If you see good players like this do that, then you know that there's been no shot on, really.
Yep.
Because usually a good player will always find the right shot. They might not always execute it as they'd want to, but they'll always usually play the right shot.
So Yasser's thinking about this one. He's looking at ways to open it up.
Tell you what though, I remember last time Yasser was on the stream and we kept expecting him to do like mad things and he would really dumbfound us by doing something sensible.
It's because he's changed a little bit, hasn't he, from what the Yasser we first knew. Mark says, can someone find me tip? I like that one.
Mark Hast, your tip is somewhere in Bramley. I've never seen anything like it.
For anybody who doesn't know what we're on about, Mark Hast had a little strop and...
I was lucky enough to witness it while I was doing a roving mic, and I think everybody heard it out on the internet as Mark's cue made contact with the table, shall we say, somewhat forcefully, and the tip flew off. And I think took someone's eye out behind the bar.
Omar says, hello. Hello, Omar. Hello, Omar. You well?
Good to hear from you, sir. I think Yasser will be attacking. He'll be looking for an angle, and I think this is it to get into his bad ball.
Yeah, he's got a chance here because who's in the other final? Omar's asking it. The other final is John Gillan versus Danny Tyler.
The other final?
Other semi-final, sorry, is John Gillan versus Danny Tyler.
Mr. Lamb's just keeping an eye on that game, so I'm sure he'll keep us apprised of the score.
Oh, lucky there from Yas.
Has he got another chance here, Daz, with the yellow that's in balk? Could he screw straight
screw back into it?
Yeah.
Possibility.
Chances there. I'll tell you what I'm going to call it, Daz. He's going to screw back into it and he's going to plant the red into the bottom pocket. There you go, I've got
it. Right, you've called it. 1-0 Gillan. John Gillan 1-0 up against Danny Tyler in the other semi.
John John Gillan 1-0 up in the other game, but I think it's fair to say that Danny's maybe not a name we'd have expected to see in the semis, and I mean no disrespect at all to Danny there, just with the field that we've got here. He's playing really well.
Omar's asking who Arfan lost to Yasser, and it was an outstanding game that we didn't stream. And I believe there's about 8 break dishes in that frame, according to Arfan. Yeah, sorry, I'll let Paul.
Arfan broke dish 3 times.
Yeah, and lost.
Yasser broke dish 5 times.
Arfan said it's probably the best someone's ever played against him.
Yep.
Which is some compliment to Yasser, is that?
Certainly is. Although we're not... No fireworks just yet in this game, although the two frames on the board were both break dishes.
You can't remember a time, Paul, I suppose.
Paul's got a chance here, actually. He's got a perfect angle if he takes a red to the middle to take the white across behind the other red that's behind the black.
I know exactly what you mean,
we're
Paul.
We're talking fractions here, but yeah. He's got that chance, I think.
Well, is it...
Well, it goes to the bottom, doesn't it? Yeah. On the top left as well, looking at it, so it would leave him plumb on the black if he did that. Oh, my goodness.
Dave Shellfish says, what are the odds for the 4 remaining? Who is favourite?
Hi, Dave. Good to hear from you, sir. Wow. Well, let's have a look. I would say Yasser, slight favourite.
Yeah.
I think that would be fair to say. Second favourite, probably... I don't really know Paul very well, so it's hard to say.
No.
I know John very well, Johnny Gillan, so probably say just John.
And Danny Tyler's played absolutely out of his skin all day today, though.
Danny has been...
So you just can't write him off.
Danny has been the enigma today, I think.
Marquez says it's yes for him because JG will be slightly inebriated. He's not that bad actually, John,
nice,
tonight.
No, he's all right. Well, yes, I just try to tie it up a little bit.
That's not heard of, is that?
Oh, Daz, I think that story you've just told me off mic, I think you need to tell on the mic to all the people who know Andy Square Crossley, our favourite barman here at 1-4. Oh, my goodness.
What's happened?
Did I just see that? Wow, have a look at the replay on that one, Daz. That's just sensational, but he's very unlucky.
That's ridiculous. Yeah, as I was saying, Richard, who's the chef downstairs, is finishing in a few days, and he's having a leaving do here, and he was just telling Square that, you know, he's leaving in a few days, and he's having a leaving do up here, you know, on so-and-so date, and he says, but you're not invited. I just caught the conversation just as us.
Poor old Square, he's a butt of so many jokes, isn't he?
He certainly
Bless
is.
Him. Bless him. Good old Richard, he's got a wicked sense of humour and he makes the best chilli ever. His chilli will be missed more than he will.
Kev says, are we sitting on the fence then? No, I call Yasser's going to win it. There we go. That's my prediction.
Yasser for me. Yep. To be fair though, Kev, we don't particularly know Paul, but we know of Paul. But we don't know him very well, so it's always hard to call for somebody we don't know. Obviously, if he's a member of that Norman's Elite team, then he's going to be a pretty special player.
Did Yasser have 2 shots there for some reason? Did I miss something? He's still at the table anyway.
Yeah,
just played
because
that one.
Paul fluked that red, didn't he?
Yes, sorry, yeah.
So he's just played with DF.
Yeah.
He must have left the touching ball, because if not, that would have been a foul by Yas.
So Yas taking the double on. And what a shot. What a shot. That creamed that.
Dead centre. Straight down the middle. So I think this is
bottom pocket.
Yeah, bottom pocket all day long. To you and I, it's a fairly tricky shot. To Yasser, it's a tap in.
Yeah, Kev says, I've cursed him now, so thanks very much. Paul's going to win now.
we've cursed everybody today, Kev. Well, Yasser just got a part of that one. Just something he didn't quite like about it.
I think he just drops this in.
Drop it
in. He's screwing into it.
He's just stunning it, I think.
No, he's done it to play it in the same part. I don't know why he just didn't drop that in.
No, but yeah, that does it all.
He's just done too much there. Dave's asking, is the chili better than Leo's curry at East Leeds? Oh, yes. Well, that's a great pot.
Oh, where's the cue ball? Same back. Oh.
No.
Oh, wow. 2-1, yes. Leo's curry at East Leeds. It's different to that, Dave, I would say. Different.
Is that still open, that?
Still open as well, I know, yeah. Is that the curry that came out once every three home games? When I didn't forget. It's not as good as the cheese sandwiches and massive bowl of chips at Northern, though. Which is all you ever got.
And they've still got them this week. Actually, of all the places that I've played at, we used to play at a pub. I forgot what they called it now. We used to play from there, and I can't remember the name of it. I'll come back to that one in a minute when I remember. The Lonsdale at Murfield.
All right.
And it was obviously the strangest place I've ever sort of played from. And they used to bring out this hot pot in the slow cooker every week.
Right.
And I'm sure it was the same one, because it got progressively worse and worse and worse, until one day when they brought it out, it smelled that bad that nobody eats it. Just and when we did it, it was stuck all the bottom of the pan and everything. Oh, it was disgusting. But I'm sure they never washed it. I'm sure it was the same one every time.
We're absolutely blessed with having Richard downstairs. Don't know what we're going to do when he goes. His chili and curry is just unreal. Unreal.
Guys, what date is the pool series event 4 on? The 4th of August?
4th of August. Rings the bell. Let me have a look on my phone.
You can just look on the date. If it...
Well, it's definitely not 4th of August. No. It's not a Saturday.
Is it the 2nd then?
Oh, Luke.
Yeah, it must be.
Tis.
Yeah,
I'm not here.
The 2nd of August, that is, Omar.
So I'll be getting slagged off again because I'm not here.
Paul Buck's not here again. Oh, we got colours here. Who's on what?
No
colours yet.
Yeah, open table.
Yeah, sorry, Omar. 4th is Monday. It is the 2nd, mate. 2nd of August. Have you read that, Paul, about the one with the 2 chicken breasts to feed 25 people and bet you got at least one of them? That is a surprise.
Betsy had both of them, never mind one of them.
Omar says, can I get in, please? I think is Omar one of the first reserves on his list at the moment? I don't know how many he's played, Omar.
I can't remember. We'll
put your name there, Omar. I don't know how many's missing on this one yet. We haven't.
Well, Arthur just said it. I think he was going to be able to make it because it's GB9.
I think holiday season as well. I'm sure we're going to have some dropouts. So I'll keep in touch with you, mate. but you are the first to ask, so I suppose you're going to get on the list.
Nice. Mistake there from
Paul. Yeah. Yeah, Omar's played two events so far.
Gary's back. I think Yasser will choose the attacking option here. He has done. Here we go. Hold on to
that's
your
a
hats.
That's a surprise there.
He was trying to disturb the bad red that's in amongst those two yellows. Just didn't get into it.
I've got main scoreboard out, not for the final.
Oh, yeah.
Bit of safety there, Paul. Well, what's... it's a changed man, is this Yasser Hussain, lad?
I know, he's getting boring.
What?
Oh, well, after two break dishes, this game sort of turned into a little bit of a
fudge fest.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great shot.
What a shot.
That is a great shot.
Just ridiculous shot. He deserves to win the frame from that shot.
Yeah,
I think.
We're just watching that. They're showing the guys on a replay. Yeah. Oh, John Ward says evening, Paul Buck.
Wardy boy, you all right, mate? Good to have you on board. How many bottles of wine you had tonight? I'll open the bidding at five.
Leanne says, I can't believe it's only a semi-final.
Yeah, semi-final, Leanne, and then final, and then we've got to clear away, so I'll see you on Tuesday.
And, yeah, obviously we won't be having anything to eat.
No, of course not.
No.
Certainly no curry.
Did you ever, this is Dave, did you ever run an event of last man standing, i.e. first name out of the hat?
Yep.
Picks their choice of opponent. We've done it a few here.
Lammy enjoys the last man standing format. We do it as kind of a subsidiary thing to our events, just for people who have gone out.
Was it Harris?
Harris. Harris Alley was the first one out of the hat. He beat about 20 people and then
lost
to the last
in final.
One got beat. He was sick. But yeah, it's a good laugh, last man standing, but we don't really do it as we just what? Johnny Walters, no wine.
Just carrots.
Leave. Just carrots. You're not on a health kick again, are you, John?
It's a lot of healthy people kicking around at the moment, isn't there? All in this healthy eating lark.
You better not be on a health kick when I meet you down in the southwest in a few weeks' time.
Well, meanwhile, Yasser's got this beautiful long red.
Well,
so what's he looking at here?
You would suggest that for most players this would be long odds to finish here. For Yasser it's probably about evens. He can't see it, can he, does he? He's going off the top to try and get it off into the middle, yeah?
Yeah.
And my eyes are broken, honestly. I need a new set of eyes. I should have just let Mark Ace take him out with his tip.
Well, he tried it with a few people, so...
It's still pinging around the room, actually, I think. It's not stopped yet. I just got out of the way pronto. Well, a little bit unlucky.
Yeah.
Okay. He probably didn't want it to follow it in. He'd want that yellow still to be there, but he's still in decent shape, Paul. Is Paul the captain of Normans? I
don't know, actually.
He's or isn't, actually. Sensational team. Very good team.
Yeah, quite a few of them here today.
Yeah, good to see them. We've had Steve Mills in a couple of times, haven't we? He's attached to Normans, and he's also the England captain.
Yeah, Steve's been over a few money matches. He's been over.
Yeah.
Matt Brearley's played.
Nice guy. Very nice guy.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Steve Mills, captain, and Norman's elite there. Paul, it's been answered for us by
Steve.
Kev.
All right, Steve's a captain. Thanks, Kev. Mind you, if we meet the mighty Leeds at Yarmouth in October, then they'll be going home early.
That's the way, Paul. There's confidence.
There's a bold prediction for you. Only because I don't play. I'm just a cheerleader.
Ah, you're pretty good at that, though.
Yeah.
I've seen Paul in his rah-rah skirt. And
Daz, don't tell people that.
I don't know, I saw some dodgy outfit on Facebook last night. some dodgy golfing outfit.
Oh, the white pants.
White pants and...
you got to play well in white
gold
pants.
Gold stripe down them or something, Leanne said.
just the Adidas stripes were gold, that's all.
It's funny, actually. I was in the sports shop yesterday looking at some golf tops for Portugal.
Right.
There were a nice fluorescent green one and an orange one that I were looking at.
Oh, dear.
You've got to be seen, haven't you?
Yeah. All right, I get you, Dave. No, we've never done that, pal.
Mills, he only picks a team. He doesn't even go to the bar. It's not the first time we've heard that he doesn't go to the bar.
To be fair, though, it's usually a Yorkshire trait. Is that not to go to the bar? It's not usually a Lancashire one. The Yorkshire lads try and stay away from the bar. Bit tight. So a couple of big shots here for Paul. Nailed that one. Is it too well almost? No, he's fine. He's okay. He's got a nice angle actually.
Yeah, just...
just needs to avoid the middle. Sometimes with ease, you can go off in the middle. Just needs to avoid the middle bag. And he'll be in good shape. I'm not sure whether the black passes the red to the... Yeah, it does. I'm just looking at the table. So he can go either side. He's got options.
Kev says he's just lazy. That's lazy. It is Millsy. Wow.
Well,
that's a difficult shot, is that?
Yeah, he definitely avoided the middle bag.
Yeah.
But I think I'd have been more tempted to run it around the rails there.
you don't have to worry about position. He's just got to pot the ball, but it's not easy.
Anyway, Dave, I thought you were coming back up north at some point. You probably won't get in the Leeds team anymore, mate. We've got really strong now, but, you know, we might find you a place in... no, I won't say the Bramley team, because they'll think that I'm only having a laugh. But are you coming back up north, Dave? Is that still an option, pal? Be good to see you.
That's a good point. Miss you just nearly went in that middle bag, though, there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so two frames all.
Very good black there from Paul. So two also, we've had two great dishes and then two fairly cagey frames. Pete Arundale's on his 75th cup of coffee. He's absolutely buzzing, his eyes are popping out on stalks.
Yeah, definitely not sleep tonight.
Might have a coffee myself, actually, Daz. Be lovely if Colin Hogan offered us a drink, wouldn't it?
Well, go on, Paul. What does that say? Dealer Allen. We're not that tight.
Allen must be a Yorkshireman then. No, we're not Allen. I'm a Yorkshireman. I'm not tight. That's why I'm always skint.
Do we know what the score is on the other table, Paul?
No,
Lammy, do we know what the score is over there, mate?
Lammy's just going to have a look. Have we got a little break here? Got a little break? No, we haven't.
No.
Mr. Tickle's here now. Mr. Tickle.
Mr. Tickle. is that one of the Mr. Men?
Here he is.
Well, that's a frame there to...
Have we got a little break? Well, mind you.
Yasser's back now.
And they're on a break anyway on the other table. We're going to find out the score now.
Yes, I'm sure we are. Three, two to Danny Tyler.
Wow.
I tell you, he's played exceptionally well today.
He has played well. How's he got on at the PPS events?
I don't know. I don't think he's done a great deal, to be honest. Mommy's on his 23rd bottle of water.
about 8 litres.
He's done 8 litres today.
It's like a camel.
I'd just been toilet all day long.
Yeah. What, you getting that excited about a bottle of water? Who was that?
That was Mr. Hussain.
Mr. Hussain on Reds.
He's just going to give him a point for that. Well, the final is race to what, Paul? Three?
Yeah. Dave's just put definitely on the horizon in 12 to 18 months. You've been saying that, Dave, for the last 6 years. Oh, 7 years, yeah. Oh, but it is fixed now. Well, that's good. It'll be great to see you back, pal. Will you be able to come back, though, from black belt to world rules? I think when you do come back, Dave, you'll be absolutely overjoyed when you come into 147 and see the facilities that we've got here. Absolutely magnificent venue. Oh, he's gone too far.
He's
there.
Just gone a little bit too far.
Yeah, you can just tell on his face he's not happy.
Was he?
Don't see a lot of emotion from Yas.
No, just the odd
little grimace.
Yeah. Right, yeah, I'll pass my mic on to him.
Might get him on for a frame, maybe. Just might get a guest commentator on for you guys, see how it goes.
Be good, actually, because he probably knows Paul better than we do.
Well, certainly. Did Yasser play another safety shot?
I can't believe it.
I can't. He's played more safety shots in his life.
Never known he has to play so many safety shots.
He did it last time when he was on the stream. He surprised us a little bit.
Maybe it's just changed and we don't realise.
Yeah. That's not the best shot Paul will ever play.
No, it's definitely. Does that go?
Well,
never.
Only Yasser could be looking at whether the black goes, and he's still got four balls. That's confidence for you. See, for my money, I would be looking to play the one on the left-hand rail as we look at the screen last, and just try and drop on the black into the middle.
Dave's just put, incredible club, played Lammy a few months back, I suppose that's back. Tables were a joy to play on, and a credit for all the work that you do to get the comps on. And it was back.
I forgot that you'd been up here, Dave. Yeah, I missed you, didn't I? On purpose. I think it was while I was on holiday, actually. Well, Yasser has launched an offensive here. I think he's going to try and play the one on the bottom rail and get a blackout in the same shot.
Yeah,
here we go.
He's almost looking at.
Looking at it now. He's looking at the action at the angle. Action Stations guys, we're going to DEFCON 3. Well, I think he's trying to get into it,
he hasn't. So he's going to have to play a good positional shot, Paul.
He is indeed.
So he takes this one over the pocket. He wants to get back round to...
Red to the same bag.
Yeah.
If he can take the white down that side, I think he's got the black into the bottom left.
He's looked at it a couple of times, hasn't he? So
yeah.
He's looking where... That's where he wants the white.
Yeah, he's looking at the angle, so... Well, this will send a message if he gets out here.
Well, if anybody can, it's Yasser.
No, but how's his angle?
Oh, I think he's all right. I think he's got...
Yeah, he's got a slight angle.
He's still got an angle on that.
He's probably having to force it just a tad more than he would have liked, but if he can get the white anywhere down below the middle bag...
It must go that because it must be tight because he looked it three or four times now.
Wouldn't surprise me if he goes and tries and gets into it. Does
I'm sure if Lammy might have a look and see if it goes. Does that go, Lammy?
Lammy's having a look, but with Lammy's eyes, it's debatable.
He's looking as if to say, it don't go, doesn't that?
Player to get on it. Has he got lucky? Oh,
wow. If it goes, I tell you lucky. What, if that goes, it's a fantastic shot. Right. Wow, it's... well, it's so tight, is this? It's unbelievable.
Let's see. It'll probably fly in, won't it?
Yeah. What a shot.
Because I tell you what, if I hadn't had that extra roll, it'd have been a foul.
Yep.
Fantastic shot. Well, this is a high quality game of pool.
Think we're having a guest commentator now.
I'll sit down for this one. Oh.
Shit. There's a lot of wires. Headphones and microphone there.
Well, massive pleasure to welcome a guest commentator into the booth. None other than Matt Braley, who's...
cheers, Paul.
Good to see you, Matt. You've not had the best of days today. How tight was your group?
Oh, it was ridiculous, wasn't it? The group of death, that one. It's every game, the first four games, we all 7-6. It's tough going.
So, I mean, just by virtue of the fact that you lost a game 7-5 as opposed to 7-6, you've gone out.
Yeah, that's just crazy, really. Yeah, when you win your first two, you think you're going to be doing it, but quality there from Liam.
Yeah, it was good, but it's been great to see you. I mean, you were certainly one of the favourites for the event, so to go out of the group stages was a bit of a shock. Have you enjoyed it anyway, though? Have you had a good day?
Yeah. Still been a good day. I'm still here, so yeah.
Yeah, it's good. It's great that you're still here. And you'll obviously know a lot more about Paul than we will, so tell us all about him.
Well, he plays for our Norman's elite side. He's quality player, you know. He's very steady. Don't tend to do anything, you know, sort of too much with the weight or anything. Everything's sort of nice and easy, but yeah, he's a good player.
That's good.
He's in our money match team next week, you know, but
that's going to be some game. Yeah, look forward to watching that one, actually. Yeah. Two very good teams.
Yeah.
Norman's elite are certainly setting a standard at interleague level, I think, Matt.
Yeah, we're doing well at the moment. I mean, I think our last four times down Yarmouth, we've won one, two finals, semis.
That's awesome. Yeah, really great standard. I mean, I play for Leeds and we've got a decent team, but, you know, sort of getting to Sundays really our sort of yardstick, really. But for you guys, I think anything less than the final, I suppose, is a disappointing for you.
If you don't make it to the Sunday nowadays, it's a disappointment. Yeah. Whereas going back a few years ago, we were the same. You know, it was aim for the Sunday. If you got there, you was buzzing with it. So,
I'd love to follow in your footsteps. You know, that'd be good.
Yeah, you got a lot of good players around here, haven't you?
Yeah, there's a few. Yeah, Yeah, it's I think it's harnessing it and getting them all together. You know, lads like to play with their mates and stuff. So it's
It's tough to get them all in the same team, really.
Yeah, I think if we got the best sort of nine players from this area, we'd arguably have the team capable of winning it.
Yeah, but, without a doubt. I mean, with the likes of with Yasser and Arfan and Stefan, and there's a lot of good players around here, aren't there?
Yeah, there is. Mikkel, Chris Mellin.
Well, I don't think you'll I don't think you'll get those down there, but I mean they're different class, aren't they? Yeah. If you got those in the team, but
they're talking about playing for our interleague team actually, so you never know, because Mickey's back on the EPA side of things now, so you never know.
Quality signings,
good pals with us, so you know, they might play, but we've got bigger fish to fry, I think.
Put a bit of fear into people, haven't they?
Yeah, I mean, Chris has certainly got bigger fish to fry now. He's on the snooker tour,
he's doing well. He's made some money in his first event there, hasn't he?
Yeah, he was here today. He came and said hello, so it was good to see him. So this is real high quality game. Really enjoying it. You probably won't know Yasser that well, but he's a very sort of flamboyant player. But he's playing quite cagely here.
He's slowed himself down a little bit, hasn't he, in this game. But I mean, they both started off with a dish off the break each, didn't they? Both nice finishes, and they're both playing pretty well. But obviously, it's getting late. You're going to see the odd mistake and that now. Right? It's
absolutely tough.
Concentration levels are hard to keep up, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. It's difficult. I think pool players are notoriously bad early in the morning and late at night. So far, touch wood, it's been a fantastic game and a really good event. Yeah. So,
not sure what time you're predicting the final to be on or finished at. It's going to be a late one.
It's crikey, it's 10 past 11 now. It's certainly going to be after midnight, I would imagine.
Bit of a mistake there from Yasser. It's tough to get into, really, wasn't it?
With that angle.
Yeah, didn't have a great angle on it.
So is Paul the kind of player then that will just tuck him up, or will he go for game himself?
He's always looking for the safety option, Paul.
That's not what we want to hear at this time of night. To be fair, his offensive game has been pretty good from what I've seen so far. Like you say, a very steady player.
He's very capable, and if he's on it, you know, he can reel off a few finishes, but you know, he tends to play the safer shot, make sure of it, really.
Is he a regular in the Normans team, Ben?
Certainly is. Yeah, he's been in all the teams that have done well down there. Yeah, he's always playing, isn't
he? If he's getting his name on that team sheet, I think that's the only endorsement that you need, really. So, that's a good shot. Just slowing Yasser right down. Essentially making him play that yellow that's blocking the two reds, although I can't see the yellow will be moving too far. But of course Yasser's got to hit a cushion after contact, so he can't trundle it too much.
Yeah, so he's just going to try and thin off it and get on back on the back rail there.
Yeah, that's not a bad shot. Has he left Paul the red to the middle?
No.
If he has, it's certainly an opportunity.
Yeah, I think Yasser probably wants to tempt him into it, really, here, because otherwise he's in a bit of trouble, really, isn't he? He needs Tickle to go for it and maybe open it up for him.
Yeah, that's right. It's the only way that he can pinch a frame.
Yeah.
So have you driven over to Dave and Matt?
Got to drive back. Yeah,
got a red eye.
A good hour back or so, and drop Tickle and JJ off, so it could be a really right one for me.
Have they enjoyed it?
Definitely. Yeah. I mean, both picked up money on it, and both played pretty well today. I think JJ was a little bit disappointed there to go out in the quarters. He had his chances, really, from 6-4 up.
He played some really good stuff, and then he seemed to let his concentration lapse a little bit at times, which I was quite surprised by. Because he's quite an intense fella, quite surprised that he let his concentration lapse. But when he was playing good, he was really hot, he was really on it.
He played a couple of loose shots at 6-4, and then at 6-5, a little bit too aggressive.
He
could have quite easily tied John up and pretty much guaranteed game, and he went for the flamboyant shot, really, didn't he?
I think to lose in a way, he lost as well, accidentally fouling the ball.
It's never a good way to go out. Yeah. And especially when he looked to be pretty much perfect as well, didn't he, really?
Yeah, so. He did, yeah. So Paul has taken that red on into the middle.
Yeah, it's going for it.
I'm good at predicting the shots, I'm just not very good at playing them, Matt.
Yeah, I think his next positional shot's going to make or break the clearance, really, isn't it? Ideally, the one that's near the black, you'd want to leave until the end and set the black into the bottom corner, but you may be forced into taking it on.
Yeah, I think you might be, actually. Would you be taking it now, Matt, or would you be doing what Paul's doing, take the top ball?
I'd be tempted to taking the one into the bottom left and coming back out to sort of like the midpoint between those two reds.
Yeah.
And give yourself the option then, basically, of either dropping the one in the middle or taking the one in the corner.
Fair play. Yeah, Paul is just making sure in his own mind. I don't mind his shot. He won't be looking to. He's played it harder than I thought he would. Yeah. I was just going to say he won't be looking to play this hard for that very reason.
Yeah, he's gone to get that one out from near the middle pocket, which I didn't really feel he needed to. No. I mean, it goes in easy enough.
He's still got the double, I think, Matt.
I'd be surprised if he took a double on his. He's one of the world's worst at doubling, so I think
I don't think he's much choice, really. It's funny, isn't it, with doubles? Some players just seem to nail them every time, and others, like you say, just can't get a double full of no money.
It's weird, pretty straight. You'd fancy getting it all there, but he's definitely not very confident at doubles.
Right. Do you use a system when you're doubling, or do you just use the feel, use the force?
Yeah, that's it. It's just, I don't know. You're either reasonably good at doubles, are you not, really? And they just seem to come pretty naturally for me. I quite like them, but Tickle seems to close his eyes every time.
I actually played one in Yarmouth where I used a two-table system, you know, where you look sort of two tables away and pick a point, and I picked a chair leg.
Oh, there we go.
Has he flipped it? No.
You can see the speed that it hits it. He's just not confident with doubles. I mean, it was fairly straightforward.
He wasn't.
He's looking, overlapping now. He obviously knows what Alvin's saying.
Yeah. But yeah, when I used this two-table system, I picked a chair leg, but when I actually got down to my shot, I was looking at the wrong chair leg, and I literally doubled the ball into the middle of a bottom cushion, and everybody just fell about laughing. So this is a fairly elementary finish now for Yasser. It looks like it's going to go 4-2. I'm going to refrain from saying 4-2 to Yorkshire while Matt's in the commentary booth with me. I don't like that. Yeah, so Paul will be just kicking himself a little bit there.
Yeah, it was a big chance, really, wasn't it? You
know, yeah, yeah.
He looked like he got into quite a decent position.
Yeah.
I mean, probably should have, you know, maybe taken that one down the rail, the confident shot, bring the white back, and everything was dropping, really, from that point. But it was a bit of a wild shot, what he ended up with.
Yeah, I don't know, it's a statement of the obvious, but 4-2 is very different to 3-all, isn't it?
The big swings out, you know, it's one frame, but it just suddenly it feels like a mountain to climb them.
And if Yasser gets another one, then, yeah, it's really difficult. Races to seven are not hugely long races, really. Not for players of his standard, anyway. Yeah. They can rattle off three and four frames.
That's it. You only have to make one or two mistakes, and that can be it, can't it, really? Yasser, confidence is with him after beating Arfan, and you know, you don't want to give him too many chances, really.
Yeah, I mean, Arfan said that it's the best that anyone has ever played against him.
Yeah, well, I watched the match, and gotta say Yasser was very good in it. He didn't miss much at all.
He's a very sort of enigmatic player, you know. One day he'll look like he can never lose, and then another day he'll do three or four mad things, really. And
he seems to have slowed himself down a lot for this one, so you know, he's definitely up for it. But
yeah,
it's, that game against Arthur and the black that he took out to win it was a fantastic
wasn't it? It was sensational. Yeah, that's a good shot from Paul to get him off and running in this frame.
Yeah, he's just got the black to worry about here.
Yeah, you would think that the yellows are pretty much a join the dots exercise map, yeah. But like you say, the black's not going anywhere, I don't think, at the moment. It's probably going to have to disturb it.
Could be better for him.
Does he try and go into the black now, Matt, off this ball?
Cut it in fairly thin. I mean, he'd leave himself a chance in the middle if he can do, just check it onto it.
Yeah.
Looks like quite a nice angle.
I think you're getting a bit of stick on the chat there.
Shamrock. There's another Norman's Elite player there, Kev Holland.
Kev, yeah.
The luckiest player around.
He says he is bobbins at doubles. Yeah. Might offer him some coaching on doubles.
Yeah, to be fair to Kev, he's a cracking double.
Well, he's. I think Paul's tried to do what we said and tried to get another black. He just didn't get the check that he needed.
He's never checked it, and now he's in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, I think Yasser will be licking his lips here, even with two reds on the cushions.
Yeah.
And Danny Tyler's having a absolutely fantastic day. He's 6-2 up against John Gillen, which, you know, certainly no disrespect at all to Danny, but certainly wouldn't have expected that scoreline.
Yeah, I've never seen Danny actually. Is he a local lad then?
Yeah, I think he's. I don't know if he's one of the York lads. I can't remember actually. There's a few lads come from York to play. I'm not certain, to be honest, Matt. He plays on the Premier Pool Series on our tour, but he's.
They're saying, I can't believe you didn't get through, neither can I. After winning my first two.
Yeah, it's harsh. If you win two games, you would normally expect to be through, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Like I say, just.
That's a fantastic shot there from
what a Paul. Brilliant back heel from Paul there. We've got the benefit of the internet stream there, which is slightly behind the one live that we're watching, and we get the replay. He's played that superbly well.
And opening the black.
That's certainly one of the shots of the day that we've seen on the stream. Can he capitalise on it?
Let's see. He's still got a little bit of work to do. They can maybe screw it in and nudge the yellow down, possibly.
Yeah, there's not a lot of room to work with between those two yellows. I think he's running into the other yellow, whether he likes it or not. Just how much control he can get on it.
And then he's still going to have to get across for black or possibly take it into the middle, maybe.
Yep. He won't be leaving a double, I don't think.
I don't think so.
Ah, wow, he could avoid it.
But I don't think he'd have wanted to there.
Yeah, I don't think he wanted to. I think he might have just wanted to nudge it coming back off the cushion, maybe, Matt.
Either that or maybe if he thought he was going to clip it on the way and he had the side on to flick it off the rail, you know.
Yeah, yeah. So he's got a little bit of trouble here. Can he? Is there any argument here for playing this with a lot of right hand side?
And I think definitely it's got to be, and I think it'll be slightly wild. I think you'll probably have to go across a couple of times, won't you? Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Just do a little bit of luck, maybe catch the red if you're lucky.
Good effort.
It's not a bad effort, and he's not the black, though. It's not the worst shot in the world.
I was going to say, he'll take that as a consolation. I think Yasser will probably have a wry smile on his face there.
Yeah, I think he'll have expected to come to the table a little bit easier.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Paul's just gone massive favourite in this frame. It's work to do for Yasser. He can tie him up a little bit, but.
Yeah, it's a kind of game that Tickle likes us, to be honest. We could be here for a little while with this one.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. So Danny's got a chance for game on the other table there.
Certainly looks like it. No. I think his chances might have just gone. Yeah, Yasser's played a decent shot there. He's just got the red over there just to mess it up a bit.
He has covered it, which it possibly Paul's looking at come off the rail, which I can't see that being a good idea.
Oh, Danny closed it out, actually. I just took my eye off that game for a minute, but it looked like his chance had gone, and he made it happen. Well done, Danny Tyler. Oh, that's a sensational shot.
Fantastic shot.
Wow.
It's been a little bit unfortunate. I mean, he's got a shot into the top bag, but it's by no means an easy one. Plays it the right way, maybe keep the bag.
Yep. To play that shot, though, and avoid the red and the black and pop the yellow is
superb.
That's
shot.
Great, Kewin. I think he deserves to get this after that shot. So difficult when you're so close to the object ball, isn't it, to find the potting angle.
Judge it appropriately.
Especially going right up the table.
Yep.
But he'll want to get the pace right on this, Matt, because I would suggest that if he doesn't pot it, he wants to leave it over the bag just to give Yasser something to think about.
He's got to make sure you don't catch it too thick.
So difficult to get the right potting angle here when you're so close.
It's a bit too thick.
Not got the pot. Has he got the cover? It's not bad. It's
Danny Tyler, the first player.
I think the red had just about go off it there.
Well done, Danny, and lucky John.
Oh, just heard Daz in the background there. You got any games coming up yourself, Matt? Have you arranged any matches, any money games or anything like that?
There's one potential one that was mentioned tonight, which is Cy Phillips.
Right.
I don't know him so much myself, if I'm honest. Somebody just mentioned it to me tonight, said that he's up for it. So
yeah,
I've seen a little bit of him and he looks like a quality player.
Well, if you look on our YouTube channel, there'll be a few games with Cy's played. Very good player, solid player. Very good demeanour around the table. It would be a sensational game if we can get that one on.
Yeah, well, I think he... I think he played Yasser before I played Stefan.
Yeah. He did. It was
not
really
sure what the
game.
Result was there. But I know he won.
Yeah, Cy won. Something like 15-11, I think. Yeah. My memory's shocking, Matt. but it was something like that. It was a really good game. It set things up nicely for your game.
Yeah.
Great curtain raiser. It'd be a fantastic game. I hope we can get that one on. You'll probably find Cy a little bit different to the players we have played before, actually. He's a lovely guy.
Yeah.
But at the table, he's quite menacing, almost. And I don't mean that in a nasty way. He's not aggressive or anything like that. It's just his body language is really good. I mean, that's not the sort of thing that'll faze you, of course. I mean, you've been there and done that and worn a T-shirt, but he's also a sensationally good player. He doesn't miss a lot, so
yeah,
it'd be a great game. Look forward to that. In the meantime, Yasser has probably
Yasser's
seen
weighing
something.
Up the double.
Yep. Got it.
Nailed it.
He's a good doubler of a ball, actually, Yasser. Doesn't miss many doubles.
It could be tough to get perfect on this if he's going to be playing it into the rail off the black.
Yeah.
Play it with a decent amount of run inside to try and flick it and maybe leave the red into the opposite corner bag.
Yep. He's almost squeezing it in, isn't he? He's sort of compressing it between the rail and the black, and usually you get that double kiss
Yep.
that takes it in. tricky.
Yeah, it's a little bit, yeah. Yeah.
Well,
left the back double.
He'll probably take that. Left across double though, as you say. Is it a bit too tight for a cross double, I think, Matt?
I don't think it'll matter particularly, close his eyes anyway, so it'll be... You never know, he might get it in the middle instead of corner.
I don't think he can avoid it.
Oh, right, yeah, I get you.
I think he's just giving a frame away there. Unless it's touching, if it's touching.
But if it's touching, it's such an easy safety shot, then the one you can have your white right down the other end at the table.
It's obviously not touching because he's playing at it. Oh, a little bit of a gift there for Yasser.
He should have definitely been taking the double.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, he's nailed it. Oops, giving him an extra frame there.
He can get it.
All right, Matt, well, thank you very much indeed for joining me in the commentary booth. It's been a pleasure talking to you, as always. Top guy, and we do hope that the game comes off with Si. We'd love to host it. It'll be fantastic.
Cheers for that. It's not quite the stream I wanted to be on. I was hoping to be on the table there playing, but it's been good.
That's great.
Cheers for that.
Cheers, Matt.
We'll get the game on.
Thanks, pal. Cheers. Thanks for your time. Enjoyed that bit of insight there with Matt. Enjoyed chatting with him. Cracking lad. Always very welcome here at 147. Smashing player.
Certainly is. He was in the group of death, wasn't he, earlier?
He was indeed. He's missed out on an appearance in the knockout stages by one frame. But, you know, a lot of players would be ruining the look. Matt just shrugs his shoulders and says, well, that's how it is. And that's...
What a break that was, by the way.
He's absolutely murdered it, hasn't he? I think he might just turn to Paul and say, you pick my colours for me here. It's a bit of a difficult choice. They're both so easy. He says, sat in the commentary booth. Yeah, reds, I think, all day actually. Yeah.
He's going to go yellows now. Yellow.
That's Yasser all over, isn't it?
Thanks,
this probably just wants a bit more of a challenge.
Make us look like fools.
Well, he's certainly playing well here, Mark.
He's been frightening.
Paul's no muck by any means. It's been a long day.
Yep, but we've still got another final, another match to go.
Oh, well.
Just stabbed at that a little bit. That's why they got reds, because of that ball, but...
Yeah. Paul was sort of stood there and he looked kind of resigned to going 6-2 down, and he leapt forward when Yasser missed that ball.
He did.
He was just stood chatting with Matt, who's just stepped out of a commentary booth.
So what do we know about, what have you learnt about Paul from your chat with Matt?
He's a very steady player, won't do anything too flamboyant. He's like the exact opposite of Yasser, I suppose.
Right.
He's a regular, he's a mainstay in the Normans Elite team, so I think that tells you all you need to know about him. I mean, you know, that's the only endorsement that he needs.
I've seen him today and I've seen him throw away some big leads to then have to take the deciding frame, which... Takes some minerals, but you know he's made mistakes, but now he's going to have to do it role reversal here. He needs to come back, doesn't he?
He's a very steady player. He doesn't look like anything particularly phases him.
No, not at all.
So he'll just be coming off a cushion and back out for the red into the middle. Yeah, he's played that well. Nice steady roll. Certainly no heroics needed here. I think we're looking at 5-3 mark.
Certainly should be. I think we're...
Danny Tyler, a very interested observer, because he will be meeting the winner of this for £500.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, good shot. Cued it well. Kev Holland says that Matt is an animal on the table. Said that obviously while he was commentating with me. He certainly is. We've had the pleasure of seeing him play a few times now, Kev.
I see.
Great player.
Who's that, sorry, Kev?
Kev Holland.
Right.
Another one of the Norman's guys.
He's the Shamrock, is he?
He is indeed. Mark A said that Yasser's break should be a criminal offence.
So he's considerably slowed down as Yas this match.
Yeah, yes.
He absolutely flew against Arfon. Well, maybe Paul's slowing him down, I'm not sure. But
Matt said exactly the same, but he made a very good point that once it gets late, pool players are a little bit sluggish. They're bad early in the morning and they're bad late at night.
Yeah.
So it could be that. It could be a little bit of fatigue. It's been a really long day. You know, he's played a heck of a lot of pool, and in between that, he's had a lot of sitting around. So
yeah, he did. He was obviously waiting for the outcome of the group of death before. Yeah. So it was probably a good 3 hours before he had a game.
Yeah.
I'm on the stage, which is always unfortunate. If we were to do it again, Mr. Buck, do you reckon races to 5 in the group stages?
I'm not being clever, but I did suggest that before this one. Definitely, races to 5, yeah. Probably be a little bit clearer about the qualification from the group as well. That we had a little bit of... It wasn't entirely clear. But that's the best thing about doing this, is that we do a new event and we learn from it.
Well, we certainly try.
We've got some fantastic ideas for events coming up. We've got a few potential money matches on the boil. Matt sort of let the cat out of the bag there about one of them.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's fair enough. We do hope that that game with Cy Phillips comes off, because yeah, it'll be sensational.
I was sat there in my chair after speaking to him about that, thinking, oh, I wonder if Paul fancies a match, and I wonder if we could find someone from this neck of the woods to take Paul Tickle on.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's JJ, of course, who's always looking for a match, you know.
Yeah. Leeds-Manchester game.
Leeds-Manchester
game. Oh, I won't
be able to ring to it.
I wouldn't be able to commentate on that, Mark. I don't think. I'd find it very difficult to be unbiased. Being a dyed-in-the-wool Leodensian. But it would be great. If anyone out there is on the chat and they're interested, let us know. See if we can get some lineups.
I reckon Johnny Gillen might be interested in a match with... Who was that?
Nath has just said, yes, up the best doubles partner ever known. Evening, Matt and Bucket. Evening, Nath. Good to see you back on the chat, sir. Obviously, Matt's not with me now. He's done a couple of frames, bless him. And I think he was overawed by my commentary skills.
Well, it's easily done.
Either that or my breath.
That's also easily done.
It's been a long day. That is very unlucky.
It's a bit harsh, that.
Very unlucky.
It is a bit harsh.
He's done everything right there. Played it well, got his bad ball into play, and it's just sat on his bad ball. If he's got a touching ball, he can go off the top cushion and go for the one over the bag, down at the other end of the table. Has he got the touching ball, though? He might still choose to do that anyway, but...
does like to think about his shots. I've noticed a few mannerisms of watching him in his previous match as well. He'll quite often get down to a shot and then get back up, and he'll very often readjust himself whilst he's down on the shot.
Right, that's, you don't really want to see that, do you? Well, that's a strange shot. It was obviously a touching ball. Oh! But if it was a touching ball, I don't really understand why he didn't go for the yellow over the bag.
It was probably evil. Just fancied a contained safety, but
it's not really worked.
Yeah, I tell you what, I'm suffering already. We've not got to the final yet.
Well, surely Dylan Duller will have to do a bit of a stint in the final. They've been conspicuous by their absence.
I think Phil's in a corner feeling like you were this morning.
Is he?
He's on it. He's been on it, hasn't he?
Has he?
Slurring his words and stuff now.
Right,
so.
Okay.
Daz hasn't been too bad.
Probably do with a Brit. Oops.
Well, he's obviously tired. He must be, because I've never seen him miss this many balls.
Yeah, he's turned into a bit of an after you, Claude, as this frame. Keep trying to hand it to each other. You got to think that Paul's going to take these out now. He's going to have to take the tricky one to the middle first, but he should be getting these, really. If he's at this stage of the competition, he should be getting these. Mind you, you'd say that about the shot Yasser just missed. Yeah, he's nailed it. Good shot. Will he take the plant on? He certainly will. Just needs to be controlled. Wow.
Not like that then.
Wow, why did he hit it so hard, Mark?
I don't know.
He's okay, don't get me wrong, he should be fine, but I don't really get that. Leave the yellow over the bottom bag and then all you got to do is trundle this into the middle, trundle it into the bottom, and obviously the blacks are sitting duck. Should be, shouldn't be an issue, yeah, good shot.
5-4.
It's a good game, enjoying this one.
Come back is on.
Well played, Paul Tickle. He's certainly not overawed by Yas. Yas has missed probably more balls in this match than he has all day. Kev Holland said he'll be looking, keeping an eye out for upcoming comps, getting bored of being a keyboard warrior.
Yeah, well, you should get yourself down, Kev.
If the game comes off between Matt Brearley and Si Phillips, would you be interested, Kev, maybe in having a game with one of the Leeds lads? So, Yasser with a sledgehammer break. His break has certainly improved immensely. I think he's
certainly learnt.
It's not third
or fourth playoff, is it? There is. So there's only 50 between.
Oh, give me four. Ah, well, I'm off. Oh, no. Give me third. Yeah. Tell him on.
Fuck it, I'm not surviving. There is a good point there. There's
third
or fourth playoff.
Yeah,
there's
only 50 quid between
the two.
Yeah,
because
here's the
ask one.
Well, you're going to have to wait, aren't you?
You're going to have to ask. Well,
give me.
I'll take that and then
I'll go fourth. No, I'll go fourth.
Yeah, well, I'll ask you. If he wants to split it, I'll give you 25 and choose.
I fucking know you're not fucking going over. I'm off anyway.
Well played, John.
Yeah, well played, John.
Fuck all in that, is it?
Well
done, mate.
You put it all in
your hand.
Nah,
I'm off.
Alright, boys. Nice.
Cheers, lads.
Cheers.
Well done, Johnny boy.
Cheers, John.
Great tonight.
Cheers. Sorry about that. We're just saying bye bye to John Gillen. Apologies if you heard any agricultural language in the background.
That's just standard for John.
It is indeed. Well, has he also got an angle here to pop the red and screw into the little cluster?
He's going to try. Or does that red go into the middle? He might not need to disturb him. With his pinpoint accuracy of his position.
If it goes in the middle, we'll find out. Yeah, he's playing to get on it, Mark. But
not,
he hasn't.
He's not got on it.
Commentator's curse again. Well, he's seen something. Red off the other red into the middle. That's what he's looking at.
Ooh, weren't far off.
Nearly nailed
it. Was the yellow.
So, chance for Paul. Dare I say, it's just gone a little bit scrappy.
Tiredness definitely kicking in. These guys have been at it since 10 o'clock this morning.
Yep.
It's now midnight. Well, not far off.
Yeah, I think if we keep going at this rate, we might break the record with you and Colin set for...
Wow, that's true. Kev says you don't do money matches, just as comps.
All right. Well, yeah.
Zad123 says a black ball comp would be good. That's a good shout, Zad, to be fair. We've not done one of them before. Mainly because we've not really known the rules up until recently. We've done a couple of commentaries on black ball matches now, so we've learnt the rules. But yeah, a black ball comp might be something that we look at next.
Just don't tell the EPA, we might take our cards off us.
Well, that is the other thing, yeah.
Just crazy that there should be such restrictions against playing pool. It's just mad. Yeah. Absolutely crazy.
Yeah, they certainly are, Kev. The black ball rules are very attacking, Kev's just said there.
Yeah, I think we certainly convert to the black ball rules, good rules. I would, personally, I'd love to see them take the best elements of black ball, the best elements of world rules, and just have an ultra attacking set of rules.
Yes.
You know, even to the extent where even having a free table after a foul, still having a DF, but having a free table, it'd just be... We certainly wouldn't still be sat here tonight if he had those rules.
No, that's true.
Well, Yasser's had a mad hack at that, and he's left them very nicely for Paul.
One thing I would change, sorry. Is if you the skill shot, I think you should call it.
Yeah, we've had this. Yeah, we had a long chat about this earlier actually, because Davey was on the chat talking about it, and I think we universally agreed it should be a call shot. I can remember. I went on about this earlier, but in one of our works events, it was black ball. I was hill with a player. and he's potted the black and the white's gone fizzing around the cushions and knocked one of my balls in. And of course in my mind I've won the match, but everybody says, oh no, no, that's fine. But well, you know, that's, it's just a bit of a sick note to take.
So when they call it, if they don't get it, do they lose the turn?
Bit foul, wouldn't it? I don't know. Oh no, no, if they call it and don't get it, that's fine.
Right.
But if you didn't call it and got a skill shot, then it'd be a foul, yeah.
Yeah,
if you call it and miss, then it's just, yeah, it's not an issue. Well, still got the final to play after this, and at least we don't have loads of equipment to pack away afterwards, Matt. Oh, actually, we do.
Yeah, true. Am I driving you home or are you driving?
No, I'm fine, mate.
That's not a bad thing, because I've just realised that Phil said that my petrol tank was on zero when he borrowed the car, right, really. So I was thinking I might have to go home and swap cars.
No, it's fine, but thank you. I'm being a good boy.
Good lad.
I could murder a coffee.
We could try dropping a subtle hint that somebody could murder a coffee. But yeah, falling on deaf ears, it's I'm not sure. I've got a sneaky feeling that the finalists might decide to play a shorter race.
I've certainly got that sneaky feeling. I think there might be a chop. They might chop the pot.
I'm not sure whether they'll do that. They don't know each other.
Well, I'm sort of hoping that they do. Sorry, I don't mean to demean the event. Oh, that's a great shot. Nice steady finish for it here from Paul, and we're going 5-all. Yep, Yasser just concedes a frame, so it's 5 each. Best of 3.
So Danny Tyler's just said that he won't mind a smallish money match. Well, maximum 500 a man, black ball rules. Danny Tyler, if anybody's out there that fancies it. He's obviously of his standard, he doesn't want no sharks.
He'll be playing in the final very shortly, so you can have a look, see what you think.
Penalty blacks in the final, that's a good shout. Nathan, you can't hear him on about playing Lloyd. I just said, would you play Lloyd? And he said, well, he'd rather have an easy game, really. Easier game. Yeah, although he won't back down, he'd rather have an easier game, which is fair enough.
That's a monster break from Paul.
Look at that split.
Wow. He's going to go yellows all day long.
You would think so.
We'll put you in the frame. Actually, you're already out there now. Okay. We'll get it on the Facebook, on the stream page, we'll get it out there. We'll get something organised, there'll be two or three together. We actually are quite busy, we're booked up, because obviously we have these function rooms and all that. And so there's weddings and parties and all sorts of stuff.
So as expected, he's gone yellows. Yeah, he's in good shape now. I would certainly expect him to get to a hill first from here. Just ran ever so slightly out of position, but I would imagine that he should regain it in the next shot. He might have to take the yellow long to the top right as we look at it, just to retain control of a cue ball, really. I'll play the ball at the top left and just hold on the black. He's just trusting the look a little bit doing that, though. He takes the clip to the middle, again he's trusting the look because he's losing the cue ball.
I think I'd take the long one, I don't like this shot.
No, I don't, I'd take the long one, I think.
Skid off the bottom of that black.
Yeah, it's...
It's alright, but it's getting harder.
Yeah, he's losing the cue ball no matter what he does here, I think. Yeah, I think I'd have taken the long one, just like I said, just to retain control of a cue ball. It's late at night, players get tired, it's difficult to hold it together, especially at 5-all. Yeah, that, like I said, it just got harder and harder for him, did that. But no matter what time it is, at this stage of a competition, he should be taking those out. Yass has played another snooker. This is a world record for him.
His second shot against me earlier was a snooker.
Really?
I'm like, are you having a laugh?
Cheeky so-and-so.
He'd played 2-1-2, I'd played 2-2. Second shot, snooker.
Oh, that just shows he's taking it seriously, he's in the zone.
Does anyone near the bar can murder a coffee?
Coffee? Do you want a coffee?
Yeah, please, mate, yeah.
Yeah, I'll start a final for you, mate, with this goal, and then I'll get off, mate. Thank you.
Cheers.
It's alright, just kids being tired,
aren't
they? But I will, if you don't mind, I'll get off.
Yeah, yeah.
You sure you don't
want
a drink?
I'll have a water, please. Mm. Sorry, I didn't mean to tell everybody at home there that I needed a water.
So this is one of those where you sort of half expect Paul to not only get out of a snooker, but to pot the yellow. No, he's gone for...
Ooh.
I'd have probably gone for the narrower angle and gone for the one over the bag. Don't really get that.
He may well have been, to be fair.
So another chance for Yasser. I wouldn't be surprised if he took the ball at the bottom of the table, just above the bark line, and tries to move the two that are on the top cushion. Won't surprise me in the slightest.
He stopped trying to do that as much, I've noticed. He would always sort of clatter into everything, wouldn't he, and just develop. And he seems to be a bit more, tries to play on the ball. You watch, he'll do what you said now.
No, you're right. He's done exactly as you said, Mark. He's because, to be fair, they're not that difficult anyway. They're just off the cushion, so... It'd still be a heck of a finish for him to get out from here.
Snooker's saying it's a grind. It certainly is.
John
Ward has said he's on Elm Street. That's... in relation to Paul missing that yellow in the middle.
Yeah. Yeah. I think if Paul does go 6-5 down here, he will be kicking himself, because it was a pretty straight. It's probably a finish I would half expect to take out, so.
Calm it.
I know. I'm just trying to put the emphasis on it.
Yeah.
Okay, so Yasser has certainly set his stall out here. He's going game. Great shot. Now he'd have no issues maybe leaving a double. He's a very good doubler with a ball. I'm not seeing him miss a double yet. I've probably just put the curse on him, but I've not seen him miss a double yet.
Ogie's here.
John Warder said it wasn't that easy in relation to my comment about fancying myself to suck him out. Okay, John, calm down.
Hey, up.
Wow.
Hey, what? Well, I see what he's done. He's left himself an angle, but not to swerve it.
Don't get that at all.
Confident in his long potting ability, that's what it is.
Phil Bailey with coffee, thank you, sir.
Sorry, mate. Do you want spicy?
A little bit, please.
You want what? Spicy? Spicy.
Spicy what?
Spicy.
That's what you like.
I ended up eating some cat food earlier.
Okay. Why?
Don't ask me how.
So Squares told you that one as well.
Yeah, but he told it me wrong.
Did you?
He said, I don't know how. When he told me, he said, I ate some cat food earlier. I don't know how. He went, I mean, don't ask me how.
Did you hear about the exchange between him and Richard?
No.
Just for anyone listening, Richard is the chef from downstairs at the restaurant, and he's a regular up here in the bar. French guy, he's going back to France soon. So he's telling the story that, I am leaving soon. I'm trying to do a French accent because I'll just sound Welsh. He says, I'm leaving soon. He says, he's talking to Square. Square's going, really? Right. He says, yeah, I'll leave for a couple of days. He says, I'm going to have a party up here, actually. And then he just looked at Square and he went, but you are not invited.
quality.
Poor old Square. Richard's so funny. He's mastered the English language superbly, and he's mastered the swear words absolutely brilliantly.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Oh, he's only flipped it. Oh,
Jesus, wept.
I think Paul would have been looking to the heavens if that one had gone in.
Well, here we go. He keeps hitting them hard, doesn't he?
Yeah, that was all.
He
that was always on the cards.
Hitting them hard. Thank you, Mr. Bailey. There's some sort of function on downstairs. I keep getting the thudding from the speakers vibrating through the chair into my arse cheeks.
Thanks for that information, Mark.
No, I'm guessing you're feeling the same.
Not actually, but...
You know, you got a bit more padding around your backside then.
Yasser just came over and said he's struggling to concentrate.
He's tired, he can't concentrate, and he just wants to go home.
Well, it'd be interesting to see if he does get into a final, where he's...
Well, you know...
the offer of a chop.
Purely from a financial point of view, it's 200 quid for the loser of this match. It's 350 for the loser of the semi-final, and 500 for the... Cocked up. Big bag.
I suppose.
I was there.
425 if I chopped it, then. Don't know.
Yeah, possibly.
I think I might choose to do that this time of night.
Toss a coin for the winner, or one for him to shoot out.
Yeah.
I was thinking about asking JJ if he wanted to commentate for a few minutes with you, but he's been here since 10 a.m. I've not heard him speak. Even when I gave him his money, I got a shake of the hand and that were it. Actually, no, I'm lying. I heard him nominate Reds once.
I did try doing a South African accent on the commentary earlier, Mark. It wasn't brilliant.
A bit like that shot.
It was yeah.
Just left enough of the red there.
Oh, well.
Enoughy-ish.
It does look a bit enoughy-ish.
We'll get some cue power on this one. Yeah, you can tell his body language is just, he's just shot.
Yeah.
He's just shot. He's going to go for it long in corner. But that's ridiculous.
That's
ridiculous.
For somebody whose concentration levels are starting to dip, that's not bad.
Jesus Christ.
But yeah, I mean, we're only sat in the commentary booth and we're sort of struggling a little bit, Mark, aren't we? And to be there playing and needing the mental strength to get over the line is difficult.
I'm praying for it anyway.
So yeah, Yasser must be tired. He's even taken a bit off a break.
I need to go to the loo. The 8 gallons of water is taking its toll. I'll be back shortly unless you can find someone else to...
No, it's all right, mate. So we've still got 63 viewers. Thank you very much for sticking with us into the wee small hours.
Paul at the table after a dry break from Yasser. Nothing down yet. It's a good shot. He's got lucky, I suppose, with the yellow, with the white in a top bag, but I suppose he earned a look. It's really sort of tiring now. The mental energy is pretty much on zero. We're struggling just with the commentary. So the lads who have been playing all day since 10 o'clock, it's a real war of attrition. But we need a big push just for one or two more frames. I'm not certain what will happen with the final. I would take a guess that the players would chop the pot, to be honest with you. But obviously we'll keep you posted on that. Yeah, Snooker says they're running on fumes. Yep. You're not wrong. We are in the commentary booth. And Leanne says, yeah, it won't be a curry you're ordering, it'll be a breakfast butty. I could eat a scabby horse at the moment, so I don't mind what it is. Well, just called the referee, Peter Arundale, over just to watch this one. I think because he's playing it really thin. Great shot. Oh no, he's okay. I was going to say that's so unlucky because I thought the red had gone in front of a yellow. That's a, just watching the replay of that shot, it's a cracking shot. The lesser spotted Darren Hebron has just made his way to the commentary booth. I think he must have been for a walk, maybe to Horsforth and back or something. Welcome back, Daz.
Hello, Paul.
Just saying, it's a.
I just watched that shot there. What a fantastic shot that was!
To say, you know, it's getting very attritional now. The fatigue setting in, but. They're still pulling out some good stuff.
They are.
Okay, it would be quite fitting if this one goes hill. I'm sort of hoping, Daz, that the two finalists agree a chop.
Well,
I think everybody is really.
Yeah.
You know, it's getting late.
It's very late, mate. It's very late. It's been a long, long day.
Yeah, and we've got to pack all this stuff away. It's like Cape Canaveral here. It takes a bit of doing.
Yeah, I think that might be getting done tomorrow.
Well, that's just a tired shot. It's he didn't really have any. Well,
I know Yasser said he's dead on his feet.
Yeah,
he's really struggling. Stato WY says, "What's the score on the other semi? The other semi's finished, mate.
Finished a long time
long
ago.
Long time, yeah.
Danny Tyler won it.
Yeah, beat John Gillan 7-2.
Yep."
Yeah, Snooker's saying they're running on fumes. He's dead right about that.
I think he's talking about us.
Yeah, we all are, I think. I've just got a bit of coffee, a bit of caffeine to keep going.
Let's,
well, this is a tough shot, is this? Yeah, we're always tough for that.
Very difficult.
So Yas has a chance here. And I say a chance, normally, under normal circumstances, I'd fancy Yas just to get down and mop these up, but...
He's very tired. Thank you.
then it loses some if you run it.
Well, he's tried to get into that red.
He has.
But apparently it's not as tight as it looks on the screen.
No.
So, maybe...
Is that a plant now, Paul, into top bag as well?
No, it's not a nailed-on plant, but there's a bit of distance... but there's a small gap between the two reds, so it can be made fairly easily. He doesn't have to plant it, though. He can get the other side.
Yeah, he's just looked at that, actually, now. He's just looked at getting top side of it.
That's a little bit short.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, have a think about it. Potentially, because if you can play it into a knuckle and then off the red.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, did that go straight in?
It flew in.
Straight in, didn't it?
It's really
deceiving. Well, I'm glad Peter agrees with that, though, because,
we keep saying
Peter's
this all the
time. He's a ref, so, and he says it looks completely different looking at the table and the screen. I know we keep saying it, but it is true.
Yeah. No, it doesn't at all.
So this to take it to a decider.
So TrueFan78 says, anyone nailed know it. Of people showing race at 8?
No idea what he's on about.
No, there. No, don't know what you're on about there, mate. Sorry. So 6 all. Deciding frame.
Typical. I'm not meaning to sound clever after the event, but I did sort of say that I was worried about the timings. What a pool to pack in. I mean, yeah, the group that lasted forever was a bit of a freak.
Yeah,
but
has killed us, is that? It really has killed it.
But I did say you should always do your calculations based on worst case scenario, and we had pretty much worst case scenario.
I think that was even worse than what we expected, though. I mean, when we looked at worst case scenario, we still didn't expect it to be that bad.
No, absolutely not. So, at least we know that the end is in sight in this match. There's just one frame left, so may the best man win. It's been a good game. Let's not take away from that.
Snooker says, giving the spectators what they want, a hill thriller. Well, you're right there. Marquez saying, I've seen a few six holes today. Yeah, Matt, you've been involved in most of them.
more than we wanted, really, but... It's been a great day. Let's not take away.
Oh,
from
yeah,
that.
It's been a fantastic day.
The fact that it's gone on, you know, this late is obviously we wouldn't really want it to be going on into the small hours like this, but it's been a good day.
No, would have played. I expected the supper to be over with, and
I'd be expecting to be in bed now, kicking out Zeds.
Yeah,
no, that's a good break from Paul.
Well, yellows are all on here, Paul.
They are. He's set himself up here to start to finish as he started.
Yeah,
a break dish.
Break dish.
I think Yasser would be a little bit sick if that happened. He'd probably want the opportunity to do it back. He wouldn't be getting it.
Yeah.
they've got to do on the function room downstairs, and it's like being above.
Is that what I can feel vibrating through my feet?
It's like being in Las Vegas.
There were a lot of people outside as well, Paul.
Yeah, good. My car's probably gone missing then. Well, Paul's having a good look at this. I would suggest he's got to go yell as Daz.
Is he looking at it or has he nodded off?
Oh, I'm so looking forward to bedtime. As expected, he's gone. He's nominated yellows. One big shot here, which is nailed.
That's a great shot.
Cued that so well. We keep going on about the lads, you know, playing so well despite it being such a long day, and I think that epitomised it. Absolutely fantastic shot. Cued that very well. He's got on his, well, I wouldn't even call it a bad ball, but sort of semi-bad ball, the one near the middle bag. He can take that out now, and it's been a fairly straightforward finish from there, but he had a straightforward finish a couple of frames back, and it sort of went a bit wrong for him, so I think that's why he's just taking extra care with this, making sure that he puts the cue ball exactly where he wants it. Yeah, this is a shot. Just bring it out to more or less where it is.
Yeah, I said that. Superb.
Well, Matt, when he joined me in the commentary booth, he inadvertently let the cat out of the bag about the potential money match with,
all right.
With Simon. It's not confirmed, of course, so we...
He's well up for it, though.
I've
just been talking to him about it.
I think they're both up for it, so hopefully we'll get it confirmed. But until it's confirmed, then obviously we're not going to get too excited about it. But potentially it's another mouth-watering money match that we'll bring you on the stream from 147. This is better from Paul. He's keeping the cue ball under control.
He is. He's queuing well.
He's a bit close. The yellow that he's closest to, he's a little bit too close to it, I would suggest, to take it to the top bag. Especially when...
Does he need to... He doesn't need to take it now, really, does he, though?
I wouldn't. He's looking at it, though. When you've got a bit of tension in your shoulders, these are quite difficult, because...
Yeah. He's looked at it, and he's...
At the end of the day,
backwards and forwards.
It goes in four bags.
Well, he's queuing it.
Maybe he's got a slight angle on it, so it's not as bad as it looks. He's played it well. Good shot.
Yeah, killed it well.
I think that's a match winner, Daz.
I do as well, Paul.
I like what he's doing now, Daz. He had an easy finish before and it went a bit wrong because he maybe just rushed it a bit, whereas now he's been very deliberate about this.
Yeah.
Putting the cue ball exactly where he wants it.
So one good shot now.
Yeah, he's up.
Choking his cue, having a look at it.
He would love the cue ball to be back exactly where it is now.
Yeah, that'd be ideal. Anywhere in that sort of... foot radius around there.
Yeah, the only thing that can go wrong here is if his shoulders tense up. Oh, wow. He'll take that.
he'll take
that all day long. So it's looking like Paul Tickle is going to take this one out. We'll let you know what the situation is following that, whether they're going to be playing a final or not. So please do bear with us. Stick with us just in case they are playing a final.
Yes, well done, Paul Tickle. What a game.
Wow.